सहनावतु सहनो भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं। नमामि भगवत्पाद शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः। वासुदेवेन्द्रयोगीन्द्रं नत्वा ज्ञान प्रदं गुरुं मुमुक्षूणां हितार्थाय तत्वबोधोभिधीयते।
सो आफ्टर हैविंग डिस्क्राइब्ड द क्वालिफिकेशंस नेसेसरी फॉर टेकिंग अप द इंक्वायरी इनटू द नेचर ऑफ ट्रुथ, व्हाट आर द क्वालिफिकेशंस? आई होप यू रिमेंबर। विवेकः, वैराग्यः, शमादिषट्कसंपत्ति एंड मुमुक्षुत्वम्। व्हाट इज विवेक? द एबिलिटी टू डिस्क्रिमिनेट बिटवीन परमानेंट एंड इम्परमानेंट। व्हाट इज विराग? डिस इंटरेस्ट टुवर्ड्स एवरीथिंग इम्परमानेंट। व्हाट इज मुमुक्षुत्वम्? Intense desire to know the truth, intense desire to get liberated from all kinds of psychological disorders, mental disorders. What are the shamadi shatka sampatti? Shama, dama, uparama, titiksha, shraddha, samadhanam. Shama, control over the mind. Dama, control over the senses. Uparama, ability to withdraw the mind and do one's duties perfectly. Titiksha, ability to endure the little pinpricks of life. Shraddha, faith in the scriptures, faith in the teachers and faith in God. Samadhanam, the ability to concentrate. So once a seeker has developed these virtues, he is fit to inquire into the ultimate truth. So what is the truth? Atma satyam tadanyat sarvam mithya. The self alone is real. Now the next question is, what is this self? What is atma? So Bhagavan Shankaracharya ji first of all lists down what all atmas are not. It is different from sthula sharira, it is different from gross body, different from sukshma sharira, subtle body, different from karana sharira, causal body. Also, it is different from jagrat avastha. So yesterday we were seeing what is jagrat avastha, waking state. What is this waking state? In the waking state, the sense organs interact with the sense object. So that state in which we experience the objects through our sense organs is called waking state. So who is this Atma? Atma is the witness of this waking state. Then we went to dream state. What is dream state? In the dream state, we experience a world. Yaf prapanchah pratiyate. Now what kind of world is this? This world is formed out of the impressions gained from the waking world. So in the waking world, our mind is exposed to shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha. The mind has gained certain experiences. These experiences have left certain impressions in the mind. Depending upon the depth of the impression, these impressions are projected in the dream world. So what is the necessary condition for dream? Nidra samaye. One has to get into the sleeping state. So when one is cut off from the waking world, the mind takes over. So the very same mind, in order to release the suppressions and repressions during the waking state, in order to release those psychological suppressions, it projects the mind world. Tad janita vasanaya. So yesterday we were saying, it is impossible for you to dream something which you have never experienced. Whatever you have experienced in the waking world alone will come in the dream world. So it is a player. So during waking world, the mind records, and in the dream state, the mind plays the recorded version. Yes. Now what is deep sleep state? In deep sleep, there are only two experiences. Number one, sukham. Another one, ajnanam. Bliss and ignorance. These are the two things which we experience in the deep sleep state. So why these three states have been described? It is to say that Atma is the witness of all the three states. Waking, dream and deep sleep. So Atma means who? Remember, Atma means myself. I, the true I, the real I. Who am I? I am the witness of all the three states. What is the proof that I am the witness? In all these three states, I am there. In the waking state also, I am there. I am the one who is going through the experiences. In the dream state also, I am there, because I am the one who is going through the dream experiences. In the deep sleep also, I am there, the one who is experiencing nothingness. So what is my experience in the deep sleep? What is experience? Aham kimapi na janami. I don't know anything. So even to know nothing, the experiencer should be there. There is an experiencer who is knowing nothing. That experience is Atma, that is me, the pure consciousness. There is an experiencer of bliss. That ultimate experiencer is the real me. So now, after having described the three states, now Bhagwan is going to describe the panchakoshas, another way of looking at the anatmas, the non-self. So what are the panchakoshas? Annamaya, pranamaya, manomaya, vijnanamaya, anandamaya. Now these panchakoshas are going to be described. Now first, Bhagavan takes up Annamaya Kosha. Let us chant. Annamaya kaha annarasenaiva bhutva annarasenaiva vriddhim prapya annarupa prithivyam yad viliyate tad annamaya kosha sthula shariram. Yes, what is Annamaya Kosha? So Kosha means sheath. Kosha means cover, case. So now we are going to see five different sheets or covers which cover the Atma, which cover myself. So first one is Annamaya Kosha. Maya means modification. So that which is modified by, made by, Annam is called Annamaya Kosha. What is that Annamaya Kosha? Sthula Shariram, this body is called Annamaya Kosha. So what is the description of this body? Now see, the very same Sthula Shariram is described in a different way. Earlier, another way was described. Panchikrta pancha mahabhutehi krutam satkarma janyam sukha dukhadi bhoga ayatanam asti jayate vardhate viparanamate apakshiyate vinashyati etc. That was a different way of explaining this physical body. Now see the way in which it is described. Annarasenaiva bhutva. What is the cause of birth of this body? It is born out of annarasam. Rasam means what? Product in this case. Essence. It is made up of the essence of food. It is born out of. Bhutva means born out of the essence of food. So as we all know, for this body to take birth in the mother's womb, the father's seed has to be there. Mother's ova or egg has to combine together. Both of them are born out of food. Then what? Annarasenaiva vriddhim prapya. So once it exists in the mother's womb, it starts growing. Vriddhi. Now this physical body starts growing. How does it grow? Again, annarasenaiva. By taking the essence of the food. Through food alone, this body grows. And then what happens? Then the body comes out of the womb. Again, the child grows by eating food. Right? Ultimately, what happens? Annarupa prithivyam yat viliyate. Ultimately, what is the biography of this body? Viliyate. It dissolves. Where does it dissolve? Prithivyam. Into this earth. What kind of earth? Annarupa prithivyam. That earth which is nothing but a form of food. All the food items, where does it come from? Prithvi. So prithvi is nothing but food. For the plants, etc., the mud itself is food. Worms, etc., the mud itself acts as the food. But whatever food you have, it is nothing but the modification of earth. So this is the definition of which body? Physical body. Anna Rupa Prithivyam Yadvidi Viliyate Tat Annamaya Koshaha. In short, Sthula Shariram. Now why is it called Kosha? Now see, this has to be kept in mind. It is not that Atma is inside this body and it has been covered by the body. Such idea should not be there. It's misleading. Remember, Atma is infinite. It cannot be covered by a little body. Then what does it mean, covering? How does Annamaya Kosha cover this body? Cover the Atma. Here, covering means you become so engrossed with this particular physical body that you ignore Atma. This way, Atma is covered. This way, you mistake yourself to be the physical body. This is the meaning covering. You tend to mistake yourself as this physical body, and thus you will never come to know who you really are. This is called covering. Covering doesn't mean physically covering. Okay. If you see in this world, majority of us, we are so carried away by this body. We pamper body so much. Why? We think this is me. This is called covering. Hours together we spend in beauty parlors, etc. Why? It is because of this notion that I am this. That doesn't mean you should not take care of this body. You must give proper food. You must give proper exercise, etc. So that you will be able to do the higher spiritual sadhanas. For that, body is definitely necessary. But pampering the body should not be done. Spending too much of time in polishing the body, that shows that the Atma is covered by the Annamaya Kosha. Right? This is called covering. Now, the next one.
What is the next one?
Pranamaya kosha.
Pranamayah kah, pranadyah, panchavayavah, vagadi indriya panchakam, pranamayah koshah.
Yes. What is this pranamayah kosha? So it contains two things. Pranadyah panchavayavah. These five vital air sheets starting from prana, etc. What are they?
Prana, apana, vyana, udana, samana.
Yesterday we had discussed these pancha pranas. What are their functions?
Prana, respiratory system. Apana, excretory system. Vyana, circulatory system. Udana, reversing system. Samana, digestive system.
So these pancha pranas, pranadyaha panchavayavaha plus vagadi indriya panchakam. What are these indriya panchakam? Karmendriya panchakam. Vagadi, starting from vak, etc. What are they?
Vak, pani, payu, pada, upastha.
What are they? Organ of speech, hands, legs, anus, genital organ. Five, they are called as karmendriyas. So panchaprana plus panchakarmendriya together form pranamaya kosha. It is the kriya shakti aspect of the physical body. Kriya shakti means action. The power to act comes from pranamaya kosha. Which is the energizing aspect of the body? It is the panchapranas. Yesterday we had seen how the panchapranas energize the body, give strength to it by digesting the food, converting it into energy and supplying it throughout the body, etc. So prana energizes the body, and once the energy is present in the body, the karmendriyas extract that energy and perform physical activity outside. So they, both of them together, form one group. Panchapranas, which energize the body, and panchakarmendriyas, which execute actions in the outer body. Which actions? The actions which are prescribed by the intellect, that we will see later. So once a particular decision has been taken by the intellect, the panchapranas along with panchakarmendriyas, they execute it. They don't have the ability to think or know. They only have the ability to perform action. This is called as pranamaya kosha. One group it is. Now, what is the function of pranamaya kosha? The thirst and hunger. Because it is utilizing energy. So naturally, whenever the energy comes down, it expresses as hunger and thirst. Right? So hunger and thirst is the function of pranamaya kosha. Now the question is, how can pranamaya kosha cover the reality, the atma? When hunger and thirst come, we get occupied by this hunger and thirst, which is the dharma of the body, and we forget the atma. If you see how many varieties of food is available in this world, Indian, Chinese, Mexican, Italian, one side. Even in Indian itself, there are so many varieties. South Indian, North Indian. Even in South Indian itself, we have varieties, right? Andhra style and Tamilian style. Then there are Gujarati style, Punjabi style. What does it mean? It means we have done so much of research in food. Correct? Indians have done research not only in scriptures, they have done research in food also. Why they have done so much research in food? Varieties of ways in which you can satiate your hunger and quench your thirst. Varieties of ways. So what happens? This becomes a distraction. The purpose of life is forgotten. The purpose of life is taken as eating and drinking. This becomes a distraction. That is why pranamaya kosha is also a kosha. It covers you. There are very many people who live to eat. So what has happened in them? The pranamaya kosha has taken the complete charge of their life. Thus, it becomes a kosha, a covering, right? Next one.
Manomayah koshah kaha manascha jnanendriya panchakam militva yo bhavate samanomayah koshah.
Yes, next subtler one. So annamaya kosha is the grossest. Subtler than annamaya kosha is pranamaya kosha. Subtler than pranamaya kosha is manomaya kosha. So what is manomaya kosha? Manascha, mind plus jnanendriya panchakam militva. Mind plus pancha jnanendriyas. What are the pancha jnanendriyas? Shrotram, tvak. Ears, skin, eyes, tongue, nose. Organ of hearing, organ of touch, organ of sight, organ of taste, and organ of smell. Pancha jnanendriyam. Why are they called jnanendriyam? They are called as jnanendriyam because they are the instruments through which you gain knowledge about the world. That is why they are called as jnana indriya. The organs through which you gain the knowledge from the world. Right? So what is manomaya kosha? Mind plus pancha jnanendriyas. Totally six. What is pranamaya kosha? Pancha prana plus pancha karmendriyas. So here it is mind plus pancha jnanendriyas. What is it called? Manomaya kosha. Or what is the function, what is the power it is endowed with? It is endowed with Ichha Shakti. Pranamaya kosha is Kriya Shakti. This kosha is endowed with the power of Ichha Shakti, the power to desire. Manomaya kosha is endowed with the power to desire. Now what is the desiring faculty? Mind. The function of the mind is to desire. But now, mind cannot desire unless it knows something. You cannot desire something which you don't know. You can desire only that which you know. Now, in order to know, mind has to be in combination with jnanendriyas. Because jnanendriyas help you to know and the mind desires that which it knows. So therefore, when the TV is on, when a particular advertisement keeps on coming again and again, again and again, slowly, slowly the mind starts desiring. Till then the desire was not there, but when you started seeing that advertisement, slowly, slowly the desire starts erupting in the mind. And once the desire erupt becomes strong, what happens? It sends signal to pranamaya kosha in order to get that object. So once first you desire, then you get what you desire. Getting what you desire is done by pranamaya kosha. Desiring is done by manomaya kosha. You can't desire what you don't know. For example, 100 years back, nobody desired iPad or iPhone, isn't it? Why? There was no such thing. So the desire was not there. So desire is always linked to what you know. And the knowing faculty is jnanendriyas. It provides the material of the outer world to the mind, and the mind starts forming likes and dislikes. Mind also starts forming emotions. Manomaya kosha has desires, it has emotions, it has imaginations, etc., etc. Now the question is, how does manomaya kosha cover the atma? Yes. When the mind starts desiring something, the mind becomes extrovert. So what do you mean by desire? Desire is a feeling that only if I get such and such thing, I will be happy. That is called desire, isn't it? So now see, the whole attention has become extroverted. Where is Atma? Within, right? In order to gain the ultimate reality, you have to look within. Now, what has this mind filled with desire? What has it done? It has brought your attention outward. You become extroverted. And then you start feeling, if only I have a bigger house, I'll be happy. If only I have a bigger car, I will be happy. Now see, all such desires have come. So what has it done? It has covered the Atma. Meaning, such a person will never try for self-enquiry. Right? This is Manomaya Kosha. Next what? What is next? Vijnanamaya Kosha.
Vijnanamayah kah buddhir jnanendriya panchakam militva yo bhavate sa vijnanamayah koshah.
Yes, what is vijnanamayah kosha or intellectual sheath? English translation. Annamayah kosha is called food sheath. Pranamayah kosha is called vital air sheath. Manomayah kosha is called emotional sheath or mental sheath. Vijnanamaya kosha is called intellectual sheath. So what is it? What are the components? Buddhihi jnanendriya panchakam militva. So what are they? Intellect plus pancha jnanendriyas. Intellect plus pancha jnanendriya. Manomaya kosha was mind plus pancha jnanendriya. What is intellect? Nishchayatmika buddhihi. Intellect is that which decides, which takes decisions, which discriminates. All these are functions of the intellect. Ultimate decision-making body is the intellect. Nishchayatmika buddhihi. So, buddhi plus panchat jnanendriya. Now, again, if you see, buddhi is connected with jnanendriya. Why? Because in order to take decision, you must have knowledge. And in order to have knowledge, you must be connected to the panchajnanendriyas. Now, what happens is, first of all, mind has a desire. How did the mind gain the desire? It was exposed to the world. World showed something to the mind and the mind started desiring. What will the mind do? Mind will not take decision immediately. Mind will refer the matter to the intellect. I like this. Shall I have it? This is what the mind will say. Because it is the seat of likes and dislikes. Now who has to take the decision? Intellect will have to take the decision. Now intellect will find out whether we should go according to the mind or we should, what you call, not fulfill the desire of the mind. The decision is taken by the intellect. For example, you see a nice car. So what will the mind say? Ah, such a nice car. Let me have it. What will the mind do? It will ask the intellect, can we have it? So now the intellect has to take the decision whether should I buy the car or not. So now intellect wants the information. So what will you do? It will collect the information. How much does it cost? Now that is an information. How does it gain the information? Through the pancha jnanendriya. So the information comes, it is 50 lakhs. So then the intellect say, I am not that rich. No. So who's take the decision? Intellect. Or vijnanamaya kosha takes the decision. Right? Suppose there is a nice, what you call that, chakli or something. The mind says, oh, such a nice thing, so sweet, so tasty. Can I have it? It asks the intellect. Intellect says, now intellect first analyzes the situation. What is the situation? I don't have teeth. So it may be tasty. Intellect says, no. Right? So in the same way, each and every situation, decision is taken by the vijnanamaya kosha. Decision is taken by the vijnanamaya kosha through the intellect. So intellect is connected with the jnanendriya panchakam. Now the question is, how can this vijnanamaya kosha cover the self, cover the atma? Now see, all questions arise in the intellect. All questions come in the intellect. Now the questions can be varieties. From where did this universe come from? What is space? How many planets are there in the cosmos? Right? what is there inside the atom, what is there inside the electron, what is there inside the, what you call, sea. So in this way, intellect can ask so many questions, and what does the intellect do? Intellect tries to gain the answers for all the questions. Now tell me, is there any end to the questions regarding the cosmos? Is there any end? There is no end. You can have millions and millions of questions, and each question will lead to another 10 questions. Correct? That is why there is total confusion. What is this cosmos? We don't know. Intellect will never know. So what happens? The intellect, trying to seek the answers by getting into the cosmos, it becomes extrovert and then forgets to do the most important thing in life. What is that? Self-inquiry. You will get the answers to all this only and only when you come to know who you are. Now the intellect, which is extroverted, has no time to inquire into the self. It becomes an obstruction. The very same questions rising in the intellect becomes an obstruction in the path of spirituality. Such a person dies. He may be knowing so many things, but not knowing the most important thing. What? Knowing himself. Thus, this Vijnanamaya Kosha becomes a covering. It prevents you know the most important thing, the knowledge about yourself. Vijnanamaya Kosha. Now what is the next kosha? Anandamaya Kosha. Let us chant. Anandamaya Kaha Eva Meva Karana Sharira Bhuta Avidyastha Malina Sattvam Priyadi Vritti Sahitam Sat Anandamaya Kosha. Yes, Etat Kosha Pancha. This is the last one. What is Anandamaya Kosha? Yes. All these activities of Annamaya Kosha, Pranamaya Kosha, Manomaya Kosha, Vijnanamaya Kosha is for what? Is for happiness, isn't it? The intellect decides one thing for what? Happiness. Mind desires something for what? Happiness. Every action is done for one thing. What? Happiness. Now, this happiness comes from where? So the answer is, it comes from Anandamaya Kosha. Now, there is a description of this joy or bliss or peace. Now, there is a peace which peace or bliss or Ananda which you experience in the deep sleep state and also in the waking state. So, two descriptions are given. First one, in the deep sleep state. How do you experience that bliss? How does Anandamaya Kosha gives you bliss or happiness in the deep sleep state? That is the topic taken up first. So, evameva karana sharira bhuta avidyastha malina sattvam. Yes. How do you experience peace and bliss in deep sleep? This is the topic. How does Anandamaya Kosha gives you that peace? So, start from the last. Sattvam. Sattvam means what? Mind is in a sattvic state. But there is one more term added, malina sattvam. Mind is not absolutely sattvic. It is defiled, tainted with what? Rajas, tamas. Whenever sattva is tainted with rajas and tamas, that sattva is called as malina sattva. So before getting into sattva, let us understand these three states. Mind has got three states. What are they? Sattva, Rajas and Tamas. When the mind is absolutely quiet and peaceful, that mind is called Sattvic mind. When the mind is agitated, it is called as Rajasic mind. When the mind is dull, then that is called as Tamasic mind. Now here, which kind of mind are we talking of? Malina sattva. Malina sattva means the mind which is sattvic but tainted with rajas or tamas. Now, mind when it is absolutely sattvic, it is called as shuddha sattva. Pure. Without any taint of tamas or rajas. Now, what is the nature of a sattvic mind? The nature of a sattvic mind is sukham and jnanam. This is the nature. Sukham means peace, bliss, happiness. Jnanam means knowledge. So whenever your mind is sattvic, you will have intense thirst for knowledge. Also, your mind will be at peace. This is the experience when your mind is sattvic. What are the two terms? Sukham, jnanam. Knowledge, peace. Now when sattvic mind is attacked by rajas, what happens? Sukham becomes dukkham, jnanam remains. Sukham becomes dukkham. Why sukham becomes dukkham? Because that peaceful state of mind becomes agitated. Rajas agitates the mind and gives you sorrow. Right? So then what is your experience now? My experience is, I know my sorrowful state. So jnanam is there, I know. What is the state? Sorrow. So jnanam remains. Sukham becomes dukkha. This is when sattva is attacked by rajas. Now what happens when pure sattva is attacked by tamas? Sukham remains, jnanam becomes ajnanam. So when the sattvic mind is attacked by tamas, what happens? Sukham remains. Meaning the person goes to sleep, he experiences peace and bliss, but he doesn't know that he is peaceful. That is ajnanam. Ajnanam plus sukham. This is called malina sattvam in this context, because we are going to describe the deep sleep state. So what is the experience of deep sleep? Malina sattvam. Mind is sattvic. Why is mind sattvic? Because in deep sleep, mind is quiet. Absolutely quiet. And since the mind is quiet, you experience bliss. But since you are attacked by tamas, the mind has tamas also, you are not aware of the bliss. So therefore, avidyastha. Avidyastha malina sattvam. Avidya means ignorance. So though I am experiencing bliss, I am not aware that I am blissful. Avidyastha malina sattvam. In the deep sleep state. In the deep sleep state, which is the only shariram which is active? Karana shariram. Therefore, karana sharira bhuta avidyastha malina sattvam. Got it? This is how anandamaya kosha gives you bliss in the deep sleep. Right. What about the waking state? Waking state, the next term. Priyadi vritti sahitam. This is for waking state and dream state. Priya adi, priya etc. Starting from priya. Vritti. Vritti means thought. Sahitam along with. So how do you experience joy in the waking state? So now three terms are there. The terms are Priya, Moda, Pramoda. When you see a thing, the joy which arises in the mind is called Priya. When you possess that thing, the joy arises in the mind is called Moda. When you really enjoy that thing, indulge in that thing, the joy arising is called Pramoda. Priya, Moda, Pramoda. So when you see a, what you call, very tasty, delicious food outside in the hotel, then that vritti is called as priya. You purchase it, now it is in your hand, it is available now, then the joy is called moda. When you actually eat it, the joy arising is called pramoda. Ishta vastu darshana janya sukham is called priya. Ishta vastu darshana janya sukham priya. Ishta vastu grahana janya sukham moda. Ishta vastu anubhava janya sukham pramoda. This is what you experience in the waking state. Everywhere you experience a joy. That joy is coming from which kosha? Anandamaya kosha. Same thing with dream also. In the dream also same thing happens. It is there, you get it, you indulge. Right? So this joy is coming from Anandamaya kosha. Now the question is this joy the joy of the self? Because Atma is Ananda Swarupa, Satchit Ananda Swarupa. Both of them, are they same? They are not same. Why they are not same? See, the nature of happiness which Anandamaya Kosha gives is, if you get this object, you will be happy. There is a conditional happiness. Happy because of, that is the nature of joy which Anandamaya Kosha gives. But what about the Ananda of the self? It is not because of, it is in spite of. It is your nature. You don't have to get anything. This is the difference. So how does Anandamaya Kosha covers your Atma? Anandamaya Kosha covers your Atma by telling you that, see, joy is in the outer world. If you get this, you will get happiness. Meaning what? Joy is projected outside other than you. This is how Anandamaya Kosha covers the Atma. It makes you extrovert. Makes you believe that happiness is outside. Whereas happiness is actually inside. Remember, Anandamaya Kosha is able to give that Ananda from the self alone. It is a borrowed Ananda. Anandamaya Kosha itself has no Ananda. It only reflects the Ananda of the Atma. But now the problem is, it shows you the wrong direction. So whenever I eat a delicious food, what do I feel? It is because of the food that I became happy. But what is the truth? That happiness was already there in yourself. When you ate that food, your disturbed mind became quiet. When your mind became quiet, you started experiencing the joy which was already there. That is the truth. But what will the Anandamaya Kosha do? It will misguide you. It will tell you, look, happiness is in the outer world. So thus, Anandamaya Kosha covers the Atma. Right? So, all the koshas over. Annamaya Kosha, Pranamaya Kosha, Manomaya Kosha, Vijnanamaya Kosha, and Anandamaya Kosha. Why are we studying this? We are studying to tell that we are not this. That's the purpose. So seriously the study is happening, so don't think I am this. All this discussion is to tell that this is Anatma, it is not you. Don't depend on them. This is the point. Etat kosha panchakam. Now, Bhagwan, you say this is not me. How? What is the logic? Now the logic is given. Why? This Shariratrayam, Kosha Panchakam, Avasthatrayam, etc. is not me. Why? Logic is given.
Madiyam Shariram, Madiyaha Pranaha, Madiyam Manascha, Madiya Buddhihi, Madiyam Ajnanam, Iti Svenaiva Jnayate, Tadyatha, Madiyatvena Jnatam, Kataka Kundala Grihadikam, Swasmad Bhinnam, Tatha, Panchakoshadikam, Swasmad Bhinnam, Madiyatvena Jnatam Atmana Bhavati.
Yes, why is it that all these are not me? There has to be a logic. So what does Bhagwan say? See this. Madiyam Shariram. How do you know your body? You know your body as mine. This is my body. Correct? Madiyam Shariram. Madiyaha Pranaha. These are my pranas. Madiyam Manascha. This is my mind. Madiya buddhihi, this is my intellect. Madiyam ajnanam, this is my ignorance. Correct? Iti, this way, what is your experience? Svenaiva jnayate, you know it by yourself. You know it by oneself. Just as tadyatha, Madiyatvena jnatam kataka kundalam grihadikam swasmad bhinnam. Just as you know your bangles, kataka, kundalam, earrings, griha adikam, house, etc. How do you know? How do you know your bangles, earrings, house, etc.? It is mine, isn't it? Madiyatvena jnatam. You know it as it is something yours. Therefore, tasmad bhinnam. Therefore, it is not yours. I mean, therefore, it is not you. Something known as yours cannot be you. Something known as mine cannot be me. Correct? Possessor of a thing is different from the possessed thing. Got the logic? So how do you tell your body, this is my body? What does it mean? You possess the body, therefore you are different from the body. You possess the mind, that's why you say my mind. What does it mean? That means you are different from the mind. There is a possessor-possessed relationship. So therefore the possessor has to be definitely different from the possessed. Just like you don't say this house is me, you say it is mine. When you say it is mine, what does it mean? Swasmad bhinnam, it is different from me. In the same way, now see, shariram, it is annamaya kosha. Madiyam shariram, annamaya kosha is different from me. Madiyaha pranaha madiyam manascha. Pranamaya kosha is different from me. Manomaya kosha is different from me. Madiya buddhihi, vijnanamaya kosha is different from me. Madiyam ajnanam, anandamaya kosha is different from me. Correct? Anything known as mine is different from me. This is the logic. So therefore, none of these. Tasmad panchakoshadikam swasmad bhinnam madiyatvena jnatam atmana bhavati. So therefore, it cannot be atma because it is known as mine. Now, in our scriptures, this is the way the logicians use logic to prove something. This style is just hinted at by Bhagavan. In all our scriptures, if you want to prove something, there is a methodology. What is the methodology? First one, pratitnya. Pratitnya means, what is it that you want to prove? Next is hetu. What is the logic? So pratitnya statement will be what you want to prove. Hetu is, what is the logic by which you are saying this? Drishtanta, what is the example? Or niyama, what is the rule? And then upanayaha, how can this particular example fit in this situation? This is called upanaya. Upanayaha. And finally, nigamanam, final conclusion. What should be the final conclusion? That pratitnya statement is right. Now in this case, let us see what is pratitnya, hetu, drishtanta, upanayaha and nigamanam. What is pratitnya statement? Kosha panchakam shariratrayam atmana bhavati. The five koshas, the three bodies, that is not atma. This is the pratitnya. This is the statement to be proved. Hetu, what is the logic? Madiyatvena jnatam, it is known as mine. Therefore, swasmad bhinnam, it is different from me. Madiyatvena jnatam, what is the logic? It is known as mine. What is the drishtanta? Example, kataka kundala grihadikam. Just like bangles, earrings, etc., which is known as mine, therefore different from me. So then what is upanaya? Upanaya means, how do you take this example and fit in this situation? Similarly, so upanaya is this. Panchakoshadikam madiyatvena jnatam. In the same way, just as bangles, etc. is known as mine, therefore different from me. In the same way, panchakoshas, etc. is known as mine, so therefore different from me. So what is the nigamanam, final conclusion? Panchakoshadikam atmana bhavati. The pratitnya and nigamanam is one. It should be same. As we say, hence the proof. Hence the proof means what? That is nigamanam. See the style of thinking. Now in this method, there is no flaw. There cannot be any flaw. Another very famous example given in the scriptures. Pratitnya parvato vanniman. Look, that mountain, there is fire on the top of the mountain. This is the statement. Now you are not seeing fire, but one person makes the statement, on the top of that mountain, there is fire. What is this? Pratitnya. Why do you say so? धूमत्वात्. सो वॉट इज हेतु? देर इज स्मोक. बट वॉट हैज स्मोक टू डू विथ फायर? सो देन यू हैव टू से नियम. वॉट इज नियम? यत्र यत्र धूम तत्र तत्र वन्नी. वेर एवर देर इज स्मोक देर हैज टू बी फायर. वॉट इज दैट? नियम. इट्स अ रूल. नाउ यू हैव टू डू उपनय. उपनय मीन्स हाउ डज दिस रूल अप्लाई हियर? पर्वते धूम अस्ति, देर इज स्मोक. Therefore, what is nigamanam? Therefore, parvato vanniman. There is fire on the top of the mountain. This is called logic. This is how the logicians prove. You must be able to prove this way, then only your statement will be accepted. Nyaya Shastra, etc. contains all these kinds of method of enquiry. It must be flawless. So this flawless yukti, logic, is being applied here. So then fine, sthula shariram I am not, sukshma shariram I am not, karna shariram also I am not, avastha trayam, jagrat avastha I am not, supna avastha I am not, sushupti avastha I am not, pranamaya kosha I am not, annamaya kosha I am not, manomaya kosha, no, that is also not atma, vijnanamaya kosha also not atma, आनंदमय कोश ऑल्सो नॉट आत्मा. देन द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, आत्मा तरहि कहा? तरहि मीन्स देन ही इज फेड अप. नेक्स्ट वन, आत्मा तरहि कहा? सच्चिदानंद स्वरूप. नाउ द सीकर इज फेड अप ऑफ हियरिंग टू मच ऑफ अनात्मास. देन व्हाट इज दिस आत्मा? नाउ देयर इज ए व्हाट यू कॉल सस्पेंस थ्रिलर. Not this, not this, not this. You know, in this crime thriller movie, etc., till the end, you don't know who has done that crime. You keep on doubting one after other. And ultimately, the villain comes, isn't it? And the villain is normally the one who you will never suspect. In the same way, now comes a final, what is this Atma? So here it is, Swarupa Lakshanam. Remember all those lakshanams. Here you are describing Atma as it is. Not describing something which Atma is not. You are describing Atma as it is. So what is it? Sat Chit Ananda Swarupa. Swarupa means its nature. Is Sat Chit Ananda. Three more terms are introduced. Naturally the question is, what is Sat Chit Ananda? Let us see. सत् किम् कालत्रयेपि तिष्ठति इति सत्. व्हाट इज दिस सत्? डेफिनेशन ऑफ सत्. सत् मीन्स एग्जिस्टेंस. सो व्हाट इज दिस एग्जिस्टेंस? कालत्रयेपि यत् तिष्ठति तत् सत्. कालत्रयम्, थ्री पीरियड्स ऑफ टाइम. व्हाट एग्जिस्ट इन द थ्री पीरियड्स ऑफ टाइम इज सत्. व्हाट आर द थ्री पीरियड्स ऑफ टाइम? पास्ट, present, future. That which exists in past, present and future all the time is called as Sat. Existence, absolute existence, independent existence. Now that is this Atma. Now tell me, are you existing or not? Whenever we talk of Atma, remember it is me. Tell me, are you existing or not? Any doubt? You have absolutely no doubt about your existence. That existence is being talked about here. But the problem is, we all do experience existence, but we think we are existing because of the body. Now this is ignorance. What is our feeling? Our feeling is, when the body came into existence, maybe I existed. When the body die, I will also die. My existence also will become non-existent. This is a mistake. And why is this mistake? This mistake is because of abhimana. This mistake is because of identification. When you get identified with the body, properties of the body appears to be your property. And what is the property of the body? Sthula shariram. Asti, jayate, vardhate, viparinamate, apakshiyate, vinashyati. It exists, born, grows, decays, dies. So when you get identified with the physical body, what is your experience? I am this body, so someday I will die. This is only a wrong notion in the mind. It is not real at all. Nobody dies. Why nobody dies? Because existence is your nature. Since existence is your nature, non-existence is impossible for you. In short, you are immortal. Sat means immortality. That is why we all desire to become immortal. Nobody in this world wants to die. Why? That desire is inherent in us. It is natural in us. We don't want to die. Isn't it? Why we don't want to die? We don't want to die because deathlessness is our nature. Then what dies? Body dies. But you don't die. Because you are Sat Swarupa. Again, existence can be of two types. One is Parinami Nitya, which continuously changes but exists. There are certain things which exist but continuously changes. For example, river, perennial river. It keeps on flowing. It is there. But the water is continuously changing. That is called as Parinami Nitya or Pravaha Nitya. It is real. It is ever there. But it is continuously changing. Another example is that of energy. Energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. It can only be transformed from one form to another. Isn't it? That is a conservation of energy. Energy is ever there, but the form keeps on changing. Now what about this Sat? Remember, it is Kutastha Nitya. It is not Parinami Nitya. It is Kutastha. It doesn't change. That has to be understood. This existence doesn't have any modification. It exists as it is. Kutastha Nitya it is. Unchangingly existent. This is Sat. Now what is the next one? Chit. Let us see what is Chit. Chit kim jnanaswarupaha. Chit. What is Chit? It is of the nature of jnanam, knowing. Chit means knowing principle. Now tell me, are you knowing? Are you knowing? I am not saying what, anything. Are you knowing or not? Are you knowing means are you aware? Are you conscious? Are you conscious? Yes, you are all conscious. Is there anyone who is unconscious? Even the unconscious person also is conscious of nothingness. Remember that. The term unconscious is a medical term. As far as spiritual term is concerned, there is nothing called unconsciousness. Because everywhere there is consciousness. Even the unconscious person is conscious. Of what? Of nothingness. So consciousness has nothing to do with the mind. In the medical term, when we say the person is conscious, it has something to do with the mind. In spirituality, consciousness has nothing to do with the mind. It is a totally independent entity. Mind belongs to Sukshma Sharira. This Chit doesn't belong to Sukshma Sharira. It is consciousness itself. It has nothing to do with Sthula Sukshma Karana Shariras. So what is this consciousness? It is an independent entity. And what is its nature? Knowing is its nature. It just knows, knows, knows. What does it know? Now according to our experience, I am conscious of the sound. That light of consciousness, in the light of which I am conscious of the sound, that light of consciousness is this Chit. I am conscious of form, I am conscious of color, I am conscious of taste, I am conscious of smell, I am conscious of my own existence, I am conscious of this world. Every moment we are using this conscious term, this consciousness in each and every one of us, this is the ultimate reality called Atma. In the deep sleep, what is your experience? I am conscious of nothing. You are conscious. That's why after getting up, you say, I slept well, I knew nothing. How are you able to say? You are able to say because you were experiencing nothingness. You were experiencing that sukham, anandam. Without experiencing, you can't say. So if you have experienced, what does it mean? Experiencer was there. Isn't it? Knower was there. This knowing principle in you is called Chit. It is continuously knowing. Whether your mind knows or not, it knows. That's why it is called a sakshi. Remember, avasthatraya sakshi. What is the job of a sakshi? Sakshi's job is to just watch. Just watching is called sakshi. Without interfering, it watches. The one who watches is called sakshi. Without interfering. It will not interfere. It will not suggest you, this is good, this is bad, it is wrong, right? No, it just watches. The job of consciousness is just to watch. Chit. Knowing. What is sat? Being is sat. The state of being is called sat. The state of knowing is called chit. Now remember, sat and chit, they are not two different properties. Sat is chit and chit is sat. They don't have a guna guni sambandha. For example, flower and fragrance, flower and color. So the color is the property of flower, fragrance is the property of flower, freshness is the property of flower. But remember, fragrance can go, flower can remain. Color can go, flower can remain. Right? In the same way, don't think that Atma has these properties, sat, chit, etc. Sometimes sat may go, chit may go. No. Atma is sat, Atma is chit. Not Atma has sat. No. Got it? Atma is chit, Atma is sat. Now what is the third one? Page number 78. Anandah kah sukhaswarupah. Right. Satchit Anand. Third one is Anand. Bliss. What is Anand? Sukhaswarupa. It is of the nature of bliss, happiness, peace, joy, contentment. Whatever term you may use, it is peace. Ananda is our nature. What is the proof? Proof is that you want Ananda all the time. Isn't it? This is the proof. You crave for happiness. You crave for joy. Why do you crave? It is your nature. Sorrow can be a burden for you. Can happiness be a burden for you? You can never say, I am burdened with happiness. You never say. You can say, I am burdened with sorrow. Yes, that has meaning. It is never a burden because it is your nature. The more and more you happy you become, the more and more nearer you are to your own nature. So what is moksha? Getting this ananda is moksha. Freedom from all kinds of psychological disorders is moksha. This is true spiritual progress. How do I know whether I am progressing in spirituality? You will know you are progressing in spirituality when all these psychological disorders starts vanishing. Anger, greed, jealousy, hatred, revenge, discontentment, depression, stress, strain. All those negative emotions show that you are far, far away from yourself. When all these negativities go away, when there is contentment, joy, etc., what does it mean? You are coming closer and closer to yourself. This is the purpose of all spiritual practice. Purpose of spiritual practice is not to gain supernatural powers, siddhis, to fly in the air and walk over water, etc. That is not the purpose. In fact, they are all distractions only. The purpose of spirituality is to know myself as Ananda Swarupa, joy. Joy unlimited. This is the purpose, Ananda Swarupa. And this Ananda you will get only when you know that you are Ananta. Ananta means infinite. Ananda comes from the term Ananta. Ananta means infinite. That which is infinite alone will be, that alone can experience unlimited joy. There is no limit. Who limits this joy? The limitation comes when you identify yourself with the limited equipments. When I identify myself with a limited body, my happiness also becomes limited. Because body has all imperfections. Embodiment of imperfection is this body. It's called Roga Mandiram, an abode of disease. So when you are identifying with that body, how can you be happy? So what is the method? Disidentify with the body. know yourself to be this consciousness, pay attention to this consciousness, and slowly, slowly disidentify with what you are not. Shariratrayam, Kosha Panchakam, disidentify and identify yourself with the Satchit Ananda Swarupa. Remember that qualification of the Adhikari, disidentifying from the Anityam, identifying himself with the Nityam. Now this Sadhana Chatushtaya Sampanna Adhikari has got that ability. He just needs a guidance, and now the methodology has been given, the guidance has been given. This is not you, this is you. So detach from what you are not, attach to what you are. Bas, over. Spirituality is over. What is the proof? What is the proof that you are in the right track? Happiness is the proof. More and more joy, more and more peace, more and more contentment, more and more mastery over the world. When you become a cheerful personality, then understand you are in the right track. So here, this topic gets over. Which is the topic we are covering now? Tattva Viveka Vichar, or it is called as Jiva Vicharaha or Vyashti Vicharaha, about the individual. All the discussions had been about the individual. Now the discussion is about the total. Because in this world, I have to interact with the world. Now I have understood who I am, but what is this world? So now the description of this world. From where did this world arise? This is the next topic. It is called as Srishti Vicharaha or Samashti Vicharaha. Till now what we have done is Vyashti Vichar, now Srishti Vichar, the entire creation that we will take up tomorrow. Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinah, Sarve Santu Niramayah, Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu, Ma kaschit dukkha bhag bhavet, asato ma sadgamaya, tamaso ma jyotirgamaya, mrityor ma amritam gamaya. Om shanti shanti shantihi. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om.